So we're back here at our favourite place, the poo pipe. Got brother Phil. What are you going to do, Phil?
Well, I'm going to go and take a 5-minute invertebrate sampling from both sides of the river. The one where the treatment works comes out, and then on this side, both will be a 5-minute kick sample on the bed of the river, and then we'll put each one in the trays and we'll see what we're doing. I'm wearing protective gear, face mask, because obviously there's lots of contaminants in there that I don't want to get on me. So yeah, we'll go over and see what we can or cannot find.
So all he's doing there is agitating the gravel with his feet to knock up any invertebrates living in the gravel into the net downstream. So what we catch in that, we'll then bring over to these buckets. That smell nice.
It's lovely. Really enjoyed that.
Look at all that sewage fungus attached to the ranunculus.
And down at the back there as well.
Look at it.
Yeah, it's pretty disgusting.
On a 5-minute survey like that, it should be absolutely rammed with olives.
Yeah.
Right. Different bucket, there's a little mate.
So what are you doing here then, Phil?
I'm just going to get out some of the invertebrates and just show you what's there. There's not a lot in this, really, considering what there should be. So we'll just pick out a few of the key ones. That there, it's a little freshwater shrimp there. So these you should find in huge numbers, really. There's quite a few coming around in there, but not what you'd expect. There's a cased caddis. Oh, it's got the mayfly's head in there. There's a mayfly nymph there. Now, the one thing that is really lacking in this tray is olives. All of our olive species, is one here. This one here, there, which I would have said the way it's swimming is a blue winged. They swim like a little seahorse, they rock up and down. But there is no, I can't find one caseless caddis in there, which you should be seeing quite a few of. They live on the plant matter as well, so they're obviously just getting smashed out of it.
So the mayfly nymph count?
4, 5, 6, 7, 8. About 10 12 odd, 12 shrimps, freshwater shrimps. And probably the same upwind olives as well. There's only 10 or a dozen I can see swimming around there.
Brilliant. So this is the second one, the opposite side of the poo pipe.
Yeah, when you are.
Okay. Caseless caddis.
That's from the non-polluted part.
Lovely caseless caddis. Very susceptible to water pollution now.
Straight away you see there's no fungus.
So it's nice clean weed there with no poo fungus on it.
No, nice clean weed. Plenty of inverts in that.
So you can see the difference. It's absolutely crawling with aquatic life there. Every single little inch of water has something swimming about in it.
But there's a lot of young juvenile mayfly nymphs in here, whereas in the other sample there was just big mayfly nymphs, which, you know, were due to hatch this year, so they're a little bit hardier. The smaller mayfly nymphs that were due to hatch next year will be more susceptible to pollution and everything else that's going in the river. So already I can see there's...
And also we have a fish.
Yeah, so there's a bullhead in there. Two fish. There's a little bullhead here and the other big bullhead in here. There you go, little miller's thumb. Beautiful, yeah. Next to an olive.
Another one there.
Oh yeah, another one there, look. See, that's exactly what is not living over the other side. There's tons and tons of small, really, really small invertebrates there. Look, there's a tiny, tiny, tiny little olive there. You know, there's none of those have survived the other side. There's probably 100 gammarus or more. There's just gammarus everywhere in here, which is what you should expect of a survey. You should expect to be seeing plenty and plenty of freshwater shrimps. Look at this. This is just absolutely crawling with bugs. Crawling with invertebrates of everything. Everything you'd wish to see of all shapes and sizes as well. Tiny, tiny little olives.
Look at that in the corner there, look.
Yeah, look, it's just absolutely going mad. I mean, the amount of cased caddis in here is just unreal. That is just full of cased caddis. Okay, so this is our clean water side that we've done. I mean, I've taken some out, which I'll run through in a minute, but I can't really count the shrimps in here. There's hundreds, really. The really noticeable thing with this survey and this side is all the tiny, tiny inverts. There's no tiny inverts in that one. It's all quite well-developed stuff that can withstand a bit of pollution, but this has got loads and loads of tiny, tiny olives. And here's another one here. These caseless caddis, which here, see these ones wriggling around? Them there, there was absolutely none of those in the other one. Look at all these freshwater shrimps as well. I've only just pipetted a few out. All the olive species, tiny, tiny ones, big ones. There we've got loads of cased caddis in there. I've just hooked out a few. There's just lots and lots of cased caddis. And in here, you've got all your 2 year classes of mayfly nymphs, last year's hatchlings and this year's due to hatch. And one thing we didn't get is the lovely fly we all like to see flying around in the summer, and that is the damsel or damoiselle. That is there. We didn't get any of that in the other one. Very interesting. See this little one here? Running in the micro cat? Yeah. That is our yellow maydun.
Yeah, there it is, look.
There we go. There we are. Wiggly, wiggly, wiggly. Having a lovely time. Nice clean water. See him?
So what we got there then?
Oh, just attached himself. Little blue-winged olive right there. Lovely. Very, very few of those in the last one. Yeah, he swims like a little seahorse. Right, so I've just done a second survey about 200 metres downstream, and it's even worse, really. There's actually more earthworms in here than anything else, randomly. Worms, leeches. There's a little earthworm. I don't know how he got in there, but better go on the grass, mate. But yeah, there's just, again, big shrimps, the odd cased caddis in there, and again, barely no olives. Here's a little one on the side here. But then if you go into the tray that was on this side of the river, and I just start moving it, it's absolutely alive with olives, mayfly nymphs, all sizes of mayfly nymphs, loads and loads of cased caddis everywhere. And here, like I say, you're just picking them out everywhere. The caseless caddis here,
We've done two samples on the poo side, and there's still not half the amount of invertebrates that there is in this one sample.
This is the difference. Poo pipe, no poo pipe. Dead bullhead.
Oh yeah, it is actually dead as well, isn't it?
No dead bullheads.
Look, that's been dead for ages.
There we are.
Wow, look at that. You can't get any better evidence than that. That has actually been dead, you know, good days. His, all his eyes are all misty. Wow, that is awful.
Yeah, there was three in that one. And one dead one in that one.
So, I mean, it's indisputable that that's, it's coming from that.
Yeah, 100%.
I mean, there's just no way that it could be argued against that, given this evidence, right? I mean, it's that, it's, it can't be blamed on stuff further upstream or...
No, because this sounds clear,
it's absolutely...
It's happening every day. We're on about day 20 of this ridiculous plume of nastiness going down our river.
Absolutely. 100%. Yeah, they asked, when they run me back last time, they asked if I found any fish dead. And I said, not, I couldn't find any visually.
Well, there's
but
one right
that
there.
That is the indicator.
Poor dead little bullhead.